Genesis chapter 2, verse 7, the Lord said, "And the Lord God formed man out of the dust of the ground, breathed in his nostrils the breath of life, and man became a living soul." Verse 18, God said, "It's not good that man should be alone. I will make him a helpmeet for him." Then God calls a deep sleep come upon Adam. From Adam's side, he removed a rib and made the woman and brought her unto the man. Adam said, "This is now bone of my bone, flesh of my flesh, and she shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man." Then God said that a man shall leave his father and his mother and shall cleave unto his wife, and they shall be one flesh. Genesis chapter 2, 23 through 24. And so for this reason, we have on record that God has the first institution of the home, and it was for the purpose of establishing and making a home that we have come here today for this wedding.
Kayla Danielle Denson, I love you. And I know God has created this bond of love. And because of that, I desire to be your husband. Together we will be one according to the plan and the will of God. Through adversities of the present and the unknowing future, I promise to be faithful to you. Also from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness or in health, I promise to love, guide, and protect you just as Christ does his church. I pledge to you my life as a living and loving and faithful husband. To death do us part.
On this day, in the presence of God and all of these witnesses, I vow a few things to you. I vow to you eternal love, loyalty, and fidelity. I vow to continue to be your best friend. I promise that when times get hard and the love is strained, that the commitment to our friendship will keep us on track. There is nothing I can promise you if I don't stay close to God. Know that God is my first love, and he allowed me to love myself and to love you. He brought us together, and he will keep us together. I realize that this path is ours to travel together, and I will never allow anyone into our sacred space. I prayed for you before I knew it was you, and I asked God to make me ready for you and you for me. And if I was never sure before that God would give me exactly what I asked for, you convinced me. I love your giving spirit, your caring nature, and your genuine intentions for me so much. So today, I give you all of me. I vow to love you, to honor and respect and cherish you as the leader of our family, the head of our household, and the love of my life. Brian, I love you to the moon, past the stars, and until my last breath.
I feel deep, still. every page that I write, every day of my life would not be filled without the things that my love for you now brings. For you I'd make a promise of fidelity, now and for eternity. No one could replace this love for you. I'd take your hand and heart and everything, and add to them a wedding ring. 'Cause this life is no good.